In taking a high-profile role like the Batman, Robert Pattinson knew the risks and rewards that come with a job. So he took the time to fully prepare to play the iconic superhero long before filming started.
The way you play the character to me felt like, you know, it's already your second or third movie of being the Batman. It already felt lived, and your ownership of the character was already full. What helped you the most in getting to that?
Well, thank you very much. I thought the script was great, and it was a really different, it felt quite unique in terms of, like, even I'd read a lot of the graphic novels, and it's kind of got different pieces from some of the key graphic novels into it. But it felt very unique, and I related to it in a lot of different ways.
In the years after becoming an international star in the Twilight franchise, the actor chose to collaborate with independent filmmakers to hone his skills and lend his star power to smaller films. In his return to a much bigger spotlight through The Batman, Pattinson is able to fully showcase his range and capabilities as an actor.
Batman is described as someone that's trying to find, meaning in his life. And we can see him in this film starting to find that out. Are you in the same trajectory you think as he is, or are you ahead of him, or have you already figured out, you know, what you're meant to do and what you're meant to be?
No, I mean, I don't know if I ever will, but I think it's interesting with Bruce as well, especially in this telling of the story. He thinks he's figured out what to do by being Batman, by creating Batman, and then he doesn't foresee the kind of dangerous consequences of this choice. He thinks that I'm going to die doing this. This is the end. This is the final decision I'll ever have to make. And then he doesn't see that there's a whole bunch of other hurdles which has to climb across as well.
Unlike previous versions of Bruce Wayne, writer-director Matt Reeves' version isn't portrayed as the usual playboy millionaire by day. It was a change that Pattinson welcomed.
When you think about Batman, the major things you think about is like Bruce Wayne's a playboy, and then he's Batman, and that's why you don't know. And it was really interesting that Matt had just taken that out completely in the script. And it completely changes the character. I mean, it makes, to me, a lot more sense. I mean, you're kind of, anyone who would try and dress up as Batman, it's very strange. I mean, and to have, I don't think you would have that much control over it. He's addicted to being Batman, and he's kind of, and he thinks it's the only way to live. And so when he meets Selina, it's incredibly difficult for him to even know how to react. A, because he thinks initially that she's one of the bad guys. I mean, that's kind of, he thinks in a very simple way. It's either good guys and bad guys, and you cannot be both. And that kind of, it really confounds Bruce's understanding of his reality by meeting her.
The Batman also stars Paul Dano, Jeffrey Wright, Colin Farrell, and Zoe Kravitz. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.